You can do it in coupled mode, you can do it in decoupled mode. Whatever way your heart desires. They're not good enough, guys. I'm in a good server with good FPS. You're better than them. What up, guys? Astro Manning here, back at it again with another video. How you guys doing today? Today we're going to show you guys a good way of taking out bunker turrets in 3.24.3. Since attritions are back to working, that means bunkers and SPK and comma rays are all going to shoot back at you now. So you guys are going to need to be aware of this and know how to handle these situations. So if you like that sort of thing, you know what to do. Smash that like button, leave a comment down below, and subscribe if you haven't already. Thank you guys for all your love and support. You can also hit that notification bell so you know when I go live. I bet you I'm streaming live right now because I stream live every day, Monday through Friday at 8 a.m. starting time EST. So come check me out live, hit that notification bell. Thank you guys for that. You could also hit that join button to become a member. Members also get double giveaway rewards or giveaway chances. So hit that join button and help me out where you can. Much appreciated, guys. There's also a giveaway going on right now. So yeah, Giveaway Manny, can you tell them about it? Hey guys, how's it going? Giveaway Manny here to give you some giveaway information. Thank you, by the way, Present Manny, for the introduction. You looking good out there. I appreciate it. So what are we doing? We're giving away an LTI Star Lancer Max. That's what we're doing. Speaking of LTI Star Lancer Maxes, there it is. That's what we're giving away. An LTI Star Lancer Max with both the original concept skin, this one right here, and the Citizen Con blue paint that also will come in the pack. LTI with two paints, Star Lancer Max. Yes. How is this happening? When we hit 6,000 subscribers, that is when it's happening. How do you enter? You enter by liking every video and leaving a comment in every video until we hit 6,000 subscribers, because one of those videos are going to be chosen at random to be the giveaway video. So that's how you do that. And this ship has some wonderful, beautiful things to it. So not only is it sexy in the outside, it's sexy in the inside too, with pool tables and kitchens and walkways and all those wonderful things. So don't miss out on this Star Lancer Max. By the way, there's more to it. In order to enter this giveaway, I'm going to put a code word in every single video you're going to be watching. There's going to be a code word. So make sure you're watching the videos and finding that code word inside the video. I will blatantly announce what the code word is in the video, but you just have to watch the whole video to find out what it is, because it could be anywhere in the video. So make sure you look for that code word, like the video, comment, and of course share to your friends, because if we get the 6,000 subscribers before the end of the year, then I'm going to also be giving the winner a Argo Atlas on top of it. So not only are you going to get an LTI Star Lancer Max with two paints, but you're also going to get an Argo Atlas on top of it. So let's get the 6,000 subscribers by the end of the year. Thank you guys for your love and support, and back to you, Present Manny. Appreciate you. Thank you, Giveaway Manny. You're doing awesome. I appreciate the information, sir. So let's get back to the video, guys. We're here floating in our F7A. We're going to do bunkers today. We're in F7A, we're going to do bunkers. So, we're going to start by grabbing a enemy bunker. So sometimes there are enemy bunkers that you do, right? So I'm in Crusader, and the normal bunker is like provide backup, which also isn't up right now. But there can also be an enemy bunker called Claire Criminal Nest, TPF on Daymar. So we're going to go ahead and grab this, and this bunker is going to have all enemies in it, and it's going to be just bad guys in the bunker. I said the same thing twice. It's going to have just bad guys in the bunker, yes, but what I meant to say is the turrets are going to be hostile. This is a hostile bunker, so when you show up, you're not going to be able to just land in front of it. You're going to have to deal with the hostile turret. So there's multiple ways of doing this. You guys can be like, oh, well, Astro Manny, I know how to do this. Just take a ship with a ground vehicle and go drive the ground vehicle. Yes, 100%. I recommend taking a ship with a ground vehicle that a ground vehicle could fit in. Try the Star Lancer Max. Aren't we giving that away here soon? Star Lancer Max, the Connies, the Corsair config ground vehicles, the C1, the Cuddy, a lot of things can hold ground vehicles. So if you want to take a ground vehicle and land a little bit away from the bunkers, you can do that as well. Bring a ground vehicle and drive to the bunkers. That is one way of doing this. But I'm going to show you how to deal with the turrets by shooting them. One of the issues in the current patch is that a lot of the bunkers, for some reason, don't have pips when you target them. So we're going to talk about that. We're also going to talk about how the turrets will actually engage on you from further out than you're used to. So we're going to talk about that as well. And then you got the other people go and say, Astro Manny, Astro Manny, what about if I just bring my Polaris? My shields are too strong for the bunker turrets. Well, if you have friends and you have a Polaris, sure, bring your Polaris and just blow up the freaking turrets with your Polaris and friends. But if you're soloing and you don't have friends in your Polaris, I'm going to still show you ways of taking out turrets and doing it in style. So the way I used to do it, okay, the way I used to do turret taking out is I used to come from up above, straight above, and then engage on them and strafe around them safely, or at least as safely as I can, right? Coming in. So I would come in like this and strafe around them as safely as possible and kill the turret before they kill me. And it actually still works. So you see this? This has a pip, and I can clearly just do this and land shots on the turret and kill the turret. He's gonna fire at me. I'm gonna continue to strafe like this, and he's gonna eventually die after landing enough shots on him. It's a little bit hard to land shots from 1k out, but the further out you are, the safer you are from turret fire. You see, he lands a few shots on me. I gotta keep strafing, use a little bit of boost, get further up. We're within 1k now, and I'm pretty sure I killed the turret. Boom. Done it. Okay, so that's one way of doing it. I'm gonna show you a second way of doing it in just a moment. But that's one way of doing it, especially if the pip shows up. So it's pretty 50-50 if the pip's gonna show up. But as you can see, there's another turret, and there's more turrets, okay? There's more turrets. And sometimes they spawn in late, so you have to be aware of this. This is great because I'm gonna be able to show you my second method without having to find a new bunker for you guys. So what I'm gonna do here now, this is not gonna always be feasible in every bunker situation, but in most cases it will be. I'm gonna turn on the lights because what I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna get really close to the ground. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get really, really close to the ground, within 100 of the ground. You see, we have a new altimeter that also shows the distance, the actual real distance of you and the ground, which is fantastic. It used to just be like a number that was kind of like the surface level or sea level, I mean. And now it's actually surface level. So this is so much more efficient having this new altimeter that we have. Kind of stay with underneath 100. Really, you want to stay underneath 50 or 75 if possible to sneak up on these turrets without them blowing you up. So if you stay real low to the ground, again, this won't work at every turret or every bunker because the surface might not be hilly enough. But most of the time, it's hilly enough to do this. Most of the time. If it's not, you can still stay low to the ground and the turrets will have a hard time hitting you, especially if you come from an angle that only one turret can fire at you at a time. All right, so keep that in mind. So this is another way of using the ground as cover to hide from the turrets, okay? So we're gonna stay real low to the ground, take it real nice and easy, go real slow here, guys. We're gonna get real close to these turrets, but again, we're gonna use the ground as cover. So we're gonna stay here. And then you just peek your head up. You're gonna see that they can shoot you from right there. And I'm gonna peek my head up. So I can't shoot those turrets, but that turret can definitely see us, okay? So then there's a turret there, and we're just landing shots on him. He's not hitting us. We're using the ground as cover. We're gonna let our weapons recharge. Peek back up. Land some shots on him. You could also go into precision mode. Right? You can also go into precision mode to land these shots. This is completely up to you if you want to go into precision mode or not. But you can go into precision mode, especially if you don't have a, a pip. Precision mode's gonna be great. You see how precision mode showed me that there was a rock right there? Now I know that there's a rock in the way of me and the said turret. Right? Nice and easy. Nice and easy. We're gonna let our shields come back up. And we'll pop our head up over it again. Land a full barrage. Get down. Okay. I don't prefer to do precision mode if I have a pip. If I have a pip, I am more than happy to just shoot in the pip zone. And it's taking a little while. I was expecting this to die quicker. Don't worry, we have a third method to show you guys as well. But this is just me showing you different methods of taking down said turret. My shield's actually down, so we gotta be careful of that. I'm getting impatient. You should be patient with it. Don't pop up too early. Don't let your shield, you know, don't let them win. Those turrets are definitely picking me off. So I might just switch to my third method right now because I'm getting impatient. But the smart thing to do would to just be patient with it. Just be patient with it. Land your shots. That turret's gotta be close. Maybe we're just not landing shots on it. Maybe our shots are missing. Maybe our shots are missing, so I'm gonna do my third method, okay? So the third method is again to stay within 100 of the ground, okay? So you wanna stay within 100 of the ground, look at your altimeter, and you just strafe right and left. Look, you just strafe like this. They can't hit you. They can't hit you. You're too quick. In a fighter, you're too quick, okay? Let's get up off the ground so we dodge the mountain, and you just keep strafing. Look how much easier this is. Just keep strafing. You could get fancy with your footwork here. Or you just keep strafing. You can do it in coupled mode. You could do it in decoupled mode. Whatever way your heart desires. They're not good enough, guys. I'm in a good server with good FPS. You're better than them. You're better than those turrets. Go out there and practice. It's okay to die. Go out there and practice, guys. That's how you deal with the turrets. I showed you a bunch of different methods. Now that we're here at the bunker, we might as well do the bunker anyways. I like to take out the first dude. Or I like to take the dudes outside out with my ship because I don't want to bother dealing with them. Well, I tend to take the dudes outside out with my ship. That's just me. I'm not a big fan of the enemies spawning outside, to be honest. So, I just wanted them dead as quickly as possible. I believe there's still one more outside. There's usually five outside, but it doesn't seem that way. We'll get a marker for the last couple of guys that are alive, so maybe there is one that we missed outside, maybe there isn't. I don't know. But we're here shooting turrets in a bunker mission. We might as well do the bunker on video for you guys. Turn off your engines, get out your ship, and go pew pew in the bunker. I hope you guys enjoyed the taking out turret tutorial. Like I said, I showed you a couple different methods. The second one I showed you might take some time, especially if you're not landing shots. I wish it was daytime so that it would have been easier to see what was happening. Cannons might make it easier as well to take out those turrets, but it is what it is. We're just gonna come down here, and everyone down here in this current bunker, like I said, it's an enemy bunker, so there's no good guys in this bunker, so there's no reason to hold fire. Anyone you see is going to be a bad guy. We are alone in a pretty high FPS server, so we're gonna take it nice and slow as we run through. Stay behind cover as much as possible. Check our corners. As you see, a guy came around the corner there. We don't really have cover for him, so we're risking it a bit, but we'll do a little bit of biscuit risking. A little bit of biscuit risking for sure. I'm doing too much biscuit risking, to be honest. We're gonna get this guy first. And then we'll get this guy. Holy shit. He was playing games with us. Alright, and the last guy is outside. I told you there's usually five outside. We'll go ahead and check for loot and stuff, because you never know when you're going to find something like this, ladies and gentlemen. Leave a comment down below if you want to know more about this helmet and ways to get it. Leave a comment down below. Let me know. Do you have this helmet? Let me know. Give me all that information down below. Let's loot. Let's figure it out. We got some AO3s. Don't need any of that. I do need this, Tiger Claws. Ah, they gave me a freaking gray box without Tiger Claws. That hurt my feelings. Oh well. So I'm just checking the normal bunker, or no more normal box spawns. You see, there's another one. Yes, two Tiger Claws. Let's go. That's enough to make my next video for tomorrow. I only needed two Tiger Claws to make my next video. I got it. I think I already checked this one. I did. You get two videos for the price of one. Yeah, I appreciate you guys. You know, there's going to be a video every day, Monday through Friday, for now on. And then there's also going to be a live stream every day, Monday through Friday, from now on. 8 a.m. EST is when I start my live streams. They will go on as long as the day continues to go. So some days will be 6-hour live streams. Some days will be 8-hour live streams. Other days could be 16-hour live streams. It all depends on what is going on in the situation and how much fun we're having and all those wonderful things. So do stop by the live streams. If you want to see more Star Citizen content and lots of ore gameplay. A lot of my videos will either be solo or small group orientated, because it's much easier to make videos in that kind of layout. But in my live streams, we are very org orientated and play with big groups, sometimes of groups of 10, 15 plus. So if you like to see crazy things on Polaris's and other capital sized ships, do stop by those live streams. There is a railgun in this box. We're going to go ahead and just ignore it as well. But there is a railgun. So, good finds. I have too many railguns and a wipe's about to come. So, I'm about to play with railguns possibly in the next couple of days, because we're going to lose them all in the wipe anyways. Let me know down below if you guys want to know tips on the wipe and whatnot. So, yeah. I'm going to go kill this last dude and then give you guys an outro. Do know, again, there is a Star Lancer giveaway going on. So make sure that you are commenting on these videos. And I think I'm going to give you a keyword in every single video. So I haven't talked about a keyword just yet. And I need to remember to talk about a keyword every single time that we do a video. So today's keyword is Crusader. Look at that beautiful planet. Today's keyword is Crusader. So if I remember to make my video about giveaway Manny, which I did at the beginning of this video, so everything should be fine. The keyword is Crusader. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. You know, notification bell, join button, all those wonderful things. Appreciate all the love and support from you guys. I'm gonna be pumping out content for you guys as much as possible. I'm really feeling like that full-time content creator role is stepping up. So if you guys really like this channel, we're going the long haul. I appreciate you guys. This is Astro Manny signing off. Hope you have a wonderful day. Until next time, adios. Bye-bye.